There are people who are saying, well, look, we have tried the APC, we've tried the PDP. None of them seems to be giving us the salvation that we require. I mean, there's the third card move, a red card movement. There is a third force. I mean, we've seen a number of groups come up in recent times, the National Intervention Movement, the Coalition for Nigeria Movement, even President Obasanjo, whom a lot of people believe you're close to. Are you still close to him, by the way?
Why not?
Okay, whom a lot of people believe you're close to, recently wrote a letter saying that to the effect that it doesn't seem to be salvation in either the APC or the PDP, and he was talking about a third force. What are your thoughts on that third force?
You see, for me, what we need is not just changing camps. What we need is for us to change our attitude from our hearts. We must change our ways of doing things from deep from our hearts, not just changing political parties or anything like that. Take, for example, those who left the PDP for APC. They said all sorts of things against the PDP. And now they are in the APC, and most of them are actually one leg in, one leg out. They are also, and the APC has not met the expectation of the people. When the APC, when the people voted the APC in 2015, they believe that they have said goodbye to all the problems of Nigeria. But today, I think we are worse off than ever before. So what I want to say here really is that it's not those people who are going to these parties, third force, fourth force, fifth force, who are they? Are they the same people that you know? They have been with us. We are all the same people. What we need is to be born again from our heart, change of attitude from our heart, that Nigerian politicians will sit down and really take stock, reflect on their attitude and say, what is wrong with us? Why haven't we met the expectations of the people all these years? Why? Mm. Why is it that some countries are getting it right in Africa? We are supposed to lead Africa. We must say goodbye to all those things that actually keep us backwards.
Let me quickly go to the apology now. You're the chairman of the People's Democratic Party, Mr. Uche Sekondo, says, I hereby, as national chairman, do admit that the PDP made a lot of mistakes. We are humans, not spirits. And the ability to admit is key in moving forward. But people are saying, what precisely is the PDP admitting to? Are they admitting to corruption? Are they admitting to leading or having a hand in where this country currently is? Because every time the APC, you know, refers to, you know, when they were in power, people seem to say, you know, APC, well, you're in power now, fix it. Do you think the PDP does have the moral authority to be one of those people?
Well, first and foremost, let me say this. The apology tendered by our chairman was it was in respect of things we've done wrong. First of all, imposition of candidates.
Has it stopped?
Well, we are yet to see whether it will stop or not, because the process hasn't started yet. In some few months' time, we'll start process of elections, congresses and conventions. So we will see whether it has stopped or not. But imposition of candidates was one of our sins. People wanted you, and then somebody else in a powerful position wanted somebody else. And so they crossed the names of those people who popularly won election and replaced them with choices of people of their own choice. That is imposition. Impunity is doing things wrongly all the time and without due respect to our own constitution. So it was very clear what we are apologizing for. We are apologizing against imposition. We are apologizing against impunity. We are apologizing against lack of obeying the rule of law, you know, even our constitution where we did not obey it. So we specifically say those things that we are actually apologizing for.
I don't know about your party constitution or the country's constitution.
Well, you know, the electoral law also picks certain things from the party, from the national constitution. So we were apologizing for not obeying our constitution, as well as sometimes also not obeying the national constitution. I am totally in support of fighting corruption, because that's the only way we can actually, you know, become a new nation. But every time they say that, the other day I was reading the papers that FIRS, the Federal Inland Revenue Service, they said they have raked in 2017 4.something trillion. That's only from them. We have not known. I don't know the figures from custom and other revenue generating agencies. So obviously, if just one organization is getting almost 5 trillion, what is our budget for 2017? Why are we borrowing again 13 trillion that we have been borrowing? What? So I don't really understand. If we are recovering money and then we are not actually borrowing, and life is, and, the, and these monies are being applied into areas that will make our quality of life better, I will clap for them. But what is worrying me right now is that they are claiming they are recovering all these trillions, and we don't see things changing. The quality of life is deteriorating. Things are getting worse for every day. So the question is, apart from the new corruption they are committing, what about this money that they are getting from those who looted the treasury? What is happening to the money?
At the Bola Tinubu colloquium, the 10th Bola Tinubu colloquium, in his own speech, he said, don't take the apology. They lie, they falsify, they changed figures, and for 16 years, they made false promises. Elections are already closed, of course. How do you react to a statement like this?
Well, as far as I'm concerned, Nigerians are not fools. They know who lied. They know what promises APC made to them. $1 will be $1 equivalent.
Did you see that in their manifesto?
Did you not hear them say during their campaigns? This was said directly by Buhari himself. That he will take what he will exchange will be $1 to $1.
I saw it in the
he also he also said
in an
that
advert.
He
I did also not hear the president.
He
say.
Also said that foil will be 45 naira per liter. You know that. Everybody knows that. I mean, he has never denied it. Everything they said, has anything come to pass? Nothing. To the contrary. So Nigerians are not fools. You can say all sorts of rhetorics in any colloquium and say whatever you want to say. Nigerians want to see that there's a change in their lives, that they can have 3 square meals in a day, that there's no corruption, that this government is not corrupt, and their lives have changed, they are living a better life, then they will not say, yes, this government is not corrupt. But if they used to eat twice a day during PDP days, and now they can only eat once, or none at all, can you convince such a person that there's a change? The change begins with me in my house, on my table, to see that now I can actually eat quality food, which I wasn't having before. Then I know that there's a change. But I can tell you frankly, all these things that they're talking about, Nigerians are no longer. 2019 will be a deciding year, and it will be different.
We'll take a break now. When we come back, we'll continue the discussion. Please stay with us.